The Samaritan woman is a gospel that we read during the Great Lent and during the 50 days after resurrection, and as well in the apostolic fasting. In the apostolic fasting, we read it three times. When we read it in the Great Lent, we read it for repentance. Repentance. This Samaritan woman was a common woman, being used and abused by so many people and rejected from the world. And that is probably why she came to the well in midday, in the very hot time, where usually people go to get water early in the morning or late in the afternoon. But she came in a very hot time, which shows that she is isolated. She is lonely, and she is rejected from everyone. Even she doesn't want to see anybody. She came to have water, and the Lord was waiting for her. And the Lord made arrangements to walk 6 hours and go to the well and sit there and wait for her. Can you imagine our Lord Jesus Christ waiting for you on your way? Even he didn't wait for her to come to a synagogue. He goes out for her. And this is a big lesson for all servants. Where should you meet your people? Where should you meet your brothers and sisters? Don't wait for them to come to you. You have to go for them. And you have to go on their way. The Lord, once he saw her, he started even to talk to her. And Samaritans, for the Jews, were Gentiles. Samaritans, for the Jews, were not good people, because they only believe in the 5 books of Moses, and they don't believe in any of the other prophets. But the Lord, يعني عارفين الجوز كده like what? Like Saidi, يعني. زي Saidi. Samaritan woman is very open-minded, very westernized. And then the Lord started to talk to this woman, saying, give me water to drink. Give me water to drink. And you know, She was so amazed. She was so astonished. You are a Jew. I am a Samaritan. We don't deal with each other. But the Lord pursued the conversation and said to her, if you know who is talking to you and the gift of God, if you know, you would have asked me to give you water to drink. And the woman was so confused, Sir, you don't have a bucket. You don't have anything to get me water from the well. Where can you get me the water from? And the Lord makes a big differentiation between the water of the well and the water he gives. He said to her, whoever drinks from this water will be thirst again. But whoever drinks from the water I give will not be thirst again. But he will have fountains of water inside him, which will flow to everlasting life. Fountains of water, which will flow to everlasting life. And the woman looked at him and said, well, I am tired. I am bored of coming here. Can you give me this water, please? So what the Lord was after, this conversation is after one thing. What is that one thing? He wants what from her? He wants her to want. He wants her to show need for him. Give me water. Once she said, give me water, then salvation started. You will never be saved unless you do what? You want to be saved. You will never be able to repent unless you want to repent. Do you want to repent? Do you want to be saved? Then we are on the way. We are on the way. Then the Lord immediately said to her, go and call your husband. Lord, I wanted this water. What is it to do with my husband? Yes, you can't have the water unless you call your husband and come here. She said to him, I have no husband. I have no husband. How can I bring him here when I have no one? He said, yeah, that is very true, because you have five husbands, and the one even who is with you now is not yours. So what the Lord does mean with call your husband and come? Call your husband and come. What that means? What a husband means here? The Lord knows. He was the one have? You have five husbands, gone, and the one who is with you now is not yours. So how can she bring her husband to him? What does it mean, bring your husband and the come? What is the husband here? The husband here, my beloved sins, my beloved sins. I'm not sure how many of us have got husbands like that. Means married to a beloved sin and live in it. How many of us have these beloved husbands? But the Lord is telling us all today, it is not enough to want, it is not enough to be in need to repentance, but you need to bring your husband. Bring me your sins. Bring me the ones, the things you love in this world and made you used and abused. Bring them to me. Maybe your husband is your laptop. Maybe your husband is your phone. Maybe your husband is a person. Maybe your husband is love of money. Maybe your husband is anything, anything you love away from Christ. Bring them to me. Bring them. Then she was faced with all her past. She was faced with all her sins. And what the Lord wants to say to bring your sins here? He wants her to believe that when she brings her sins to him, her husband's to him, he will forgive her. So you need salvation, and then you need to believe that he is the only one who can forgive you. He is the only one who can set you free from all your bonds, from all your burdens. You remember? It is really astonishing. Remember this sinner woman, when the people whose sin was her, who used her, who abused her, brings her to the Lord, saying she deserves to be stoned. What would you say? What would you say? We used her, but we will stone her as well. We will kill her as well. And the Lord comes in to save her, saying, whoever without a sin will start casting the first stone. And nobody could do. Nobody could do. And the Lord forgave her and set her free. then we come to the living water. The water of the well was static water, underground water. But living water is like a spring, like a spring. The Lord told this lady, whoever drinks from the water of the well will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks from the water I give will be fountains of spring, fountains of water, springs for everlasting life. عارفين ال difference between living water and wells water. The wells water is static, but the living water is like springs comes out and flows out. It's a continuous water. It's like a fountain, never stops and keeps flowing out. When the woman admitted her sins, when the woman said to him, I have no husband, he gave her this forgiveness, he gave her this living water. We hear in the Bible, yeah, when the Lord wants to, when people's sins came out up to the Lord couldn't take it anymore. So he said to Noah, go and tell them, you will build an ark. Whoever goes in the ark will be saved, but whoever will stay outside of the ark will be perished. And this water there, everyone out of the ark being perished, everyone inside of the ark being saved. It's a water to save those who are in the ark and to perish those who are outside of the ark. What is the ark? What is the ark? The ark is the church, or the ark is the cross. The ark is the church, or the ark is the cross. And again, when Moses split the Red Sea, the same water protected the Israelites, and the same water went back on Pharaoh and his soldiers, and they were perished. Why? Because they haven't believed. Because they haven't believed. And even when the Israelites went out of Egypt and they ran out of water, Moses hit the rock and the rock brought flow of water. The Bible tells us this rock followed them for how long? 40 years. 40 years the Israelites drink from this rock. How? It's a living water. The rock walked and followed them. And what is this water? What is this living water? The Lord sits with Nicodemus and say to him, unless you are born again, you cannot get into the heavenly kingdom. And Nicodemus say, Lord, how can I go back into my mother's womb? It's too small now. He said, no, unless you are born from the water and the Spirit, you cannot enter the heavenly kingdom. What is this water and the Spirit? We find the Lord on the cross coming out of his side, what? Water and the blood. And this water was the Holy Spirit who will overflow to those who believe and fulfill them with the heavenly gift, that it will be a fountain in our lives, springs to everlasting life. So the first thing is to believe. Living water was a symbol of the Holy Spirit in our lives. We firstly hear that the Holy Spirit was hovering over the water in the beginning of creation. And then we hear the flood and the burn of Sodom and Gomorrah. And I want you to notice that this living water was always joined with what? Was always joined with what? With fire. The water was always joined with fire. Water and the fire, water and the fire, water and the fire. If you notice how did the Lord treat sin, he flooded the earth, then he burned Sodom and Gomorrah, water and fire. When the Israelites went into the wilderness, they were led by a column of water, the cloud, and a column of fire at night. When Elijah wanted to finish the Baal's prophets, he offered a sacrifice. And when he put the sacrifice there, said, put water on it, and more, and more, and more water. Then fire came down from heaven and took the sacrifice, water and the fire. And even when the Lord was baptized, the Holy Spirit came and descended upon him. Even the disciples in the Pentecost, the Holy Spirit descended upon them by what? By tongues of fire. And we all had. Why am I saying all of that? To say one thing. What the Lord has given, this Samaritan woman has given it to every one of us. When? In baptism. In baptism, you being dipped in the water and came out to have the Holy Mary, the Holy Spirit in your life. And you've been given that living water, which is a fountain that will flow to everlasting life. I'm not sure, are we aware of that great power in our lives? Do you know that you have had already this living water inside you? Yes, you have it. You had it. Whether you are using it or not, that's a different matter. But you already have it. Are you enjoying this everlasting life inside you? Or are you going you back again to love other husbands? Or are you going back again to the world to look for the water of the world which would not ever satisfy you? You drink from it and getting thirsty again. You drink from it and getting thirsty again. And so on. And you never looked inside your life. And so the fountain inside you. Today the Lord is saying, this fountain is inside you. Please, please, do you know the gift of God? Do you know who gave it to you? I gave it to you, not to be thirsty again. You know what? When you are thirsty to the world, it means what? You are not drinking from this water. If you are thirsty to different husbands in this world, you are not drinking from this water. You are not drinking from the fountain which is in you. For the first time, the lady, when she drank from this living water, the Bible tells us she left the bucket. She left the bucket and went away. The Bible tells us she went to her city. She went to the Samaria. But she went to Samaria not as before. When she was before in Samaria, they were using and abusing and taking advantage of her and rejecting her. But today, she is going there with the Lord. With the Lord. To introduce him to all of them, saying what? He is my bridegroom. He is my new husband. I have no more husbands in the world. I left the bucket. And when she took the Lord and went to Samaria, praying and screaming for every one of them, I have found someone who told me everything in my life. Could he be the Messiah? Could he be Jesus Christ? Come and see. Come and see. And she went to them witnessing to the Lord. And the Lord had all the Samaritans coming out, the whole city came out to the Lord. And after they met the Lord, they told her, we now believe, not because what you have told us, but we believe because we have seen him and heard him. This is a story of a repentance which leads to what? The Lord changed her life from a sinner to a servant to a witness to bring him the whole of the Samaritans. You know what? One day, the Lord sent two disciples to Samaria. And when the two disciples went there, nobody listened to them. And they came to the Lord and said to him, would you like fire to come down and burn this city? They are not believing. They deserve to be burned. And the Lord said, don't worry. Don't worry. I don't know from which spirit you are. But, I will send one person who will repent, and he will bring all of them to me. Are you really repentant? If you are repentant, you will be a servant. You will be a witness. You will, every time, come to the church, bring some people with you. Every time you see somebody, you will talk to him about the heavenly kingdom. You will be a fisherman. A fisherman. To men. To bring the fruits 30, 60, and 100. Or are you still living in the world and being a stumbling stone for the others? I hope that we learn from the Samaritan woman how to repent, how to find the fountain of the Holy Spirit inside your life, and then you will be a different person. You will be a different, having a different aim, having a different goal, having a different behavior, having a different way of life. This Samaritan woman is telling every one of us, look at the fountain of water you have and drink from it. May our Lord Jesus Christ give us all to leave our buckets, to believe in Him, and come to admit all our sins and have our sins to be forgiven, and then drink from this living water and go out, reach the others, and bring everyone to the Lord, especially your home, your family, especially your family. You start with your family, bringing all your family to the Lord.